without some of the radio in situ, and I'm just gonna briefly turn it on, and then let's just hope that I don't Sasquatch everything up in the process. So there's the radio, it's on top of my printer. The wall wart is a transformer type, so at least they've learnt there. That's the power. Bit of noise. It's on FM at the moment. There's quite a bit of noise on the FM. I'm just hoping that it's got quite a nice sound to it. It's a very poor signal area, there's a lot of noise here. So this radio will probably get manhandled to the local hill. I don't know whether it's on the stereo, but I never use that. It's a bit bassy, so we'll turn that down. Being a bit deaf, I need a little bit more sound. So let's turn that down. I don't want to get a YouTube strike for that. And I'm not sure how to disable the stereo. There should be a thing for disabling that. Because the signals here are a little bit... hang on. Oh, the stereo was turned off. It's good, because you don't need the stereo, it's a mono radio. And it's not a good idea to use stereo down here. The signals are not very strong here. I'm in a rural area, basically down in the dip. And it's quite difficult to get stereo FM without the choppiness. And that's, as I say, the set. And what we'll do over the next few hours is have a little play with it. And because I'm not sure how the band works or how to change band. I don't know anything yet. No, it's obviously not to change the band. So that tells you how little I know. I have no, oh yeah, that's the shortwave bands. I know now roughly how to do that. So I want to check and make sure everything is working before I do an in-depth video. But it seems to be... it seems to be alive, and the RF gain with a short wave, and there's an auto. Looks like there's an auto RF gain as well. Never seen that before on a radio before. Oh. Maybe the squelch don't work until you've got that on. No, the squelch probably only works on... just a little word there. The knobs are metal. The knobs are metal on this one. They're not plastic. I just tested that. There's no plastic knobs here. You'll be glad to hear that they're all spun aluminium. I wondered whether they were plastic, and I was so that is a plus to me, that the knobs are metal, not this horrible cheap plastic. The fit and finish feels good on the knobs, and the fit and finish of the unit itself is a lot better than I actually thought it would be. And considering it's made in China and not Japan, I thought it would be something pretty awful, but actually I'm very, very surprised. If I put 1, 4, that is the amateur band of 20 meters. You won't pick up anything this time of day on there. I might not even have that right. Because it's not being very good on those bands at the moment. So it's picking up CW without the BFO turned on. I'm not sure how to turn the BFO on. Probably have to press SSB for that. But it's already receiving a Morse signal, which is now gone. Chorus tune at the moment. So it obviously is working on shortwave, which was important. But I think the one thing that does this radio for me is that it's got a reasonable size display. It's a pity that the light doesn't stay on all the time. Ah, perhaps it does. I just press that now, the light might... No, it doesn't. It keeps going out, which is annoying. Let's try and hold it in and see and hope it stays on. Because I don't like the idea of a light keep going out. But anyway, that's a quick introduction to Jeffrey's Tecsun S2000. And what we're going to do is stick up a tripod later, put it for its paces, and actually see what it's actually capable of doing. So 73 on the next video, and so we're going to go through the manual now, and because I don't know a thing what I'm doing, and we'll let you know how well I get on with it. 73s.